Greases have been in domestic and industrial use for centuries. Widely used in cooking, these oils regularly come into contact with heat and fire. Generally, this poses no danger, but if the conditions are right, the grease may catch fire. To begin with, grease is a semi-solid mixture of an oil lubricant and a thickener. The oil lubricant is a liquid that reduces friction with the contact surface. The thickener gives a semi-solid, squishy consistency, though the oil is retained in a structure and does not spread out. Oils are organic compounds made from triglycerides. The chemical properties of triglycerides are responsible for the characteristic chemical properties of grease. The properties related to the flammability of oils include their boiling point, smoke point, flash point, and fire point. The boiling point is the temperature at which the oil transitions from a liquid phase to a vapor phase. In this case, there is no chemical change of the molecules. The smoke point is the temperature at which the oil starts to give off visible smoke. Physically, smoke is a suspension of minute solids and gases in the air. At the smoke point, the oil molecules undergo a chemical change to form free fatty acids. The flash point is the temperature at which the vapors can be ignited in the presence of an external ignition source. Since the vapors are suspended in the air, the ignition of one vapor molecule sets off a chain reaction, so the nearby molecules also get ignited, leading to an explosion. The fire point is the temperature at which a continuous fire can be sustained. The process by which a fire starts is called combustion. Three components contribute to a fire: fuel, oxygen, and heat. For a grease fire, the fuel is the oil in the grease. Heat is provided by the stove, and oxygen is already present in the atmosphere. When the temperature crosses the minimum threshold, the oxygen combines with the fuel in a redox reaction, which gives off a lot of heat and light, also known as a fire. Grease fires occur when the cooking temperature rises above the flash point. First, the temperature crosses the boiling point, resulting in the vaporization of oil. As the temperature rises further, visible smoke is emitted. If the heat source is not shut down, the temperature eventually crosses the flash point, which causes a redox reaction of oil vapors and oxygen, creating a fire. Now, water and oil don't mix because water is polar and grease oil is nonpolar. The denser liquid falls to the bottom and the less dense liquid floats on top. Water is denser than oil, so when water is poured onto burning oil, some will float to the top, but the rest tends to sink. Since the temperature around the water droplets is high, they get vaporized, causing a substantial volume expansion of water droplets, pushing the oil mass away and spreading the fire over a larger area. When grease fires occur, turn off the heat source as soon as possible and cover the utensil, area, or pot with a lid. This cuts off the oxygen supply that the fire needs to continue. But most importantly, call the fire department immediately. If you like this video, then please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more stories on science and our lives. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us.